I'm not enjoying this pint at all. That's literally all I want to say. Pretty much. My name's Frenchy Kid. I'm from Romford, Howard Hill, in Essex. I've never been over there, yet. That whole, the motto of that, that is how I want people to listen to my music. I want to be like, yeah, he's just different. It's difficult talking about it, but rapping about it is different. I'm still getting used to talking about it.
Remix it. Kid from the street, I'm so real. Fuck with gorillas, I've been in that field. Done it to kill. Don't know the feeling, the enemy bleeding. It gets on my sleeve, like taking a pill. Making a deal. Fiends on the left and the right, I'm still. Shooting for veins, it might get a feels. Might get a chills. Next day alive, and he might have been killed. In the trap, my own brother's friends got me moving the crack. I was so young, I can never look back. Bro, it ain't worth it, I'll do it for racks. Don't do it to sack. Bands.
Shit. Yeah, that's all it is. Just getting used to fame. Sometimes it gets a bit on top. Walking out my door and being like, shit, I've got a bit of a following, innit? I'm actually a rapper, like, I just like my own, like, time. If I'm going shop, just put my earphones in. I don't like really, like, fucking talking to bare people. But I have to now.
Where was the next singing, bro?
You know what I'm saying, bro?
You know I'm sick, you know?
Let's catch them slipping. I see, man.
No, they're like ninja drills.
Stan's gonna be funnier if you're sick.
They just the verge, bro.
Oh, gee.
You just gotta be more careful, gotta be more cautious, because it's a fucking cruel world, isn't it? But at the same time, it's good, because you have to deal with people more. So it definitely makes you a better person. I think so, anyway.
Can I ask you one favour? One favour. My friend, yeah, he's been a fan of yours since, like, apparently 1,000 followers. Do you want to follow him on Instagram?
No, then what's his name?
Oh, my God. Okay, Dylan Kiriakou 18.
Dylan fucking, bro, that's a massive
Do you want me to type in for you?
Dylan Kiriakou.
K-Y-R.
So it's a name and a half, that, isn't
it? Follow back, look at that.
Yeah, that's so good. No worries. All right, listen.
I appreciate it so much. You're an absolute legend, man.
Here's your bags.
Can I get one selfie?
Thank you.
Push it.
It. Love, man. Love, have a good one, yeah?
Take it easy.
Somebody take us downstairs, yeah? You have to
knock. Like, people come up to you, and it took me a while, like, the whole staring thing took fucking ages. Because you got even like, oh, yeah, shit, I'm not even staring, because... But when you get past that, it's sort of... My mum's the biggest influence I've had in my life, easily.
Yeah.
She's got a little band, she goes around pubs, like, Irish pubs and that. Does little tribute acts and just, no, she's good, she loves it.
Just getting some photos in and out for covers or whatnot.
What's going on? Change man. Bro, I don't know where to start, bro. I'm a new man.
My mum used to bang out Gorillaz, like Feel Good Ink and all that. The Doors, Jimi Hendrix, Pink Floyd, Two Door Cinema Club.
Just everything, 50 Cent, Eminem, Biggie.
And then she liked Motown. I grew up on so much Motown.
Ridiculous mix of things, but I think that's what sort of built my ear to music, yeah.
Started this, the devil left me with mental issues, but it's still part of this, it's part of me. Daddy fucking left, but mommy still believe it's Lucifer. Running from the sunlight when the dark proceeds, I'm fighting all these demons in my head just like my brother did. Now I die before I fucking snitch, I learnt this from a kid. Me and my brothers and now we be riding on these silly pricks.
Does she like the kind of music?
Yeah, she loves it, plays it all the time. Literally, whenever she's working, she plays it, she be banging it out, she loves it. And I know she understands it, so it's like, like people say things, but I'm not like, mum knows and that. So it's good. It's good to like that she listens. I don't have to talk to her. She can just listen to my music, and then she knows how like how I feel about things. And it's good because she knows that like it's nice to know that she knows I'm doing all right with it. So.
Everyone's having a fucking vibe, first of all.
Mummy told me not to trap. Mummy told me stick to rap. Gypsies and Algerians in France told me to flip a pack. Used to walk my dog a strap. I just want my brother back. Sometimes I miss France, but times are dark when I was slanging crap. Mummy told me not to trap. Mummy told me stick to rap.
UK music like when you were young, like do you remember what kind of stuff was out? Was it Channel U or Biggs or?
I never saw any of that. I was in France. When grime started getting big, I just saw it on YouTube. But I was in France, like no one knew about grime. But I just obviously where I'm still from the UK, I still try keeping up as much as possible.
My stepdad's French. So when he met my mum, ended up in France pretty much. And I just got chucked in the deep end pretty much. They just put me in like any school. And the first day was mad. I can't lie. The first day was mad. You get away with a lot in France, especially where I live, so whatever my older brother was doing, I wanted to do the same thing at that point. Influenced a lot by the elders.
It was like a fairyland when I was there doing certain things, because it was just like, it's difficult to explain the kind of area. Where I'm from, it's kind of like, it's kind of mixed. There's a lot of countryside, and then there's like a city nearby, and then there's gypsies, and then there's like, it's all quite mixed.
France was good, but also bad, because I was moving it. Trust me, I ain't talking bad, no. When I see moving shit, I watch Snatch, I watch Reservoir Dogs. We were brothers in arms, because we had weapons from cunt.
Algeria, Moroccan, Italian, where I was. And it was very near to Spain, innit? So that's when I started getting into certain things because of what you can get through Spain. Where I was, like, there was a lot of like Muslim gypsies as well, like Spanish gypsies. Like most of my friends were either Algerian or gypsies over there. Everything that happened over there, whether it was legal, illegal, you could just get away with it.
But I was at a point where I was still so young that I was just like, it weren't real life, like, yeah. It was still like fucking La La Land, do you know what I mean? And that's when I started, seeing that whole community, which is completely different but similar as well to, like, the one here. One of them was, I had an altercation, my lot were drunk. These two travellers were drunk, we had a little altercation and that. And then we sweetened it, had a drink. And then, been sweet from there, innit? Others are just through other, they're all from different things, all different families. But yeah, I respect the community and I always will, to get it.
See what? I'm so proud of this shit, you know. Do you know, bro?
That's why you don't invite travellers.
I'm so proud of this shit. This you. You got blessings coming your way. Come on. Come on, man. We shut it down. Did we shut it down?
On the beers, on the fighting.
Yeah.
We're
come on. We're getting lit. We're outside, man. Come on.
It's nice outside, bro. I can't lie. This is like stylish mafia, you know? That's what we're down for. I dressed like this day today, by the way.
James Bond, who?
Yeah, trust me. Obviously the same outfit every day, so I just wash it every day.
You know? Like a hat, like a fedora.
Yeah, and the MJ one glove.
Yeah, trust me, the one glove, bro.
I had a deal with my mum. She was like, if you pass your Bravo is like GCSEs, then you can fuck off back to the UK. I was like, sweet. Didn't revive, completely winged it, and I don't know how, but I passed it. And that was my ticket back here, literally.
Yeah, this is a shot. All right, Fred, strong.
Stuck in my dream, yeah.
I started thinking, oh, I'm doing this now I want to go back to the UK and do the same thing. And then I found music.
There was definitely a culture shock when I came back. But I was like, I came back and I was like, in my head, I was like, I've got to prove myself. Like, that's just what my mentality was like when I got here.
I just came back here thinking, right, like, I'm here now, like, it's different, but let me just try and, what I was doing in France, let me try and build my name here. And it just, yeah, just it wasn't a good idea at the time, but I was young, innit, so every, like, sales, fighting, just end overnight and sales and that, like, it's good, like, when you think back here, it's funny, but Essex is like, everyone fucking has a little fucking, do you know what I mean? You go out, you have a little, like, turnout and that, have a little tear up, but, yeah, we should just take it that step further, innit, but there's loads, like, there was one night where, it's a famous night in my lot's book, where in a certain place in Essex, in a certain gaff, it was just two of us, me and my boy, just against like a ridiculous amount of people, and it was fucking mad. It was fucking mad. It ended up going way too far, and they had to shut down the club for like 2 weekends. That's pretty mad. This was in like 2016, I was 16. I got dumped by a lot of bouncers as well. I was like, mate, I got done dirt by bare bouncers, bro.
And then I went to college, just getting in trouble all the time. Got kicked out. Went to another college, got kicked out of that one. I was a little shit. I've fucking tried everything. Tried doing mastic for a bit, something called fireproofing as well. Tried doing air conditioning. Got fucking lifeguard fucking thing. I've always loved rap. Like, I listen to a lot of things, but yeah, I've always loved rap. And then I was just in this place with, in this flat with like all my boys and that, we're just chilling. And then we used to just freestyle like every night. Like in this flat in Ilford, just freestyle, smoke, have a smoke, freestyle. And then they're like, oh, and then I'd start writing down my freestyles.
Have you ever seen a real clip? Brother, can you feel this? Have you ever seen a real clip? Brother, can you feel this?
It was a freestyle I put on my Instagram, and it fucking just blew up, innit? Like, it was when I first put French and English, and no one had ever seen that yet.
And then that's when I was like, oh yeah, do you know what? I'm gonna release. Saying that's when I made Bella Latino.
Walking about and that, like, just certain places was just mad, especially around Essex. Like, I went to like our local club, like Unit 7 in Basildon, and everyone was just coming up to me, like, everyone, and I was just like, mad.
I'm in Essex a lot, so a lot of my supporters in Essex do look very similar. Like, we've got the side part of that. But then I'll go to somewhere else and my supporters will all look the same but completely different to what the Essex ones look like. So it's crazy. There's a lot of Nike running gear. Nike tech are thriving, bro, off me.
Who remembers my first tune on Link Up TV? Bella Latino.
Americano, we pop the bando, bella latina, don't say la tango. Americano, we pop the bando, bella latina, don't say la tango. Yeah.
French is, he's one of the most talented, I've probably said this, but he's one of the most talented people that I've ever met in terms of like an artist. Like I genuinely, and I felt it from like mad early, like before, as I said, when I met him, I wouldn't even, he wasn't an artist. Like French is, speak of the devil.
Look at this.
This guy is just ordering Amazon's best customer, every platform's best customer right now. What is that? Your game chair.
Yeah, bro.
All praise of fucking Obi Obaraya, literally. Oh, hello. Yeah, my manager, Obi. As soon as I met him, we just got the ball rolling and it was just like fucking full throttle from there.
I told him from the jump that I think I can do something quite special with him. Obviously, pending seeing what we can do in the studio, I just felt like there was a good energy and felt like he could be a good little brother, but we needed to go to the studio. And I put it on him.
When I first met Obs, when he first brought me to the studio, where I just had like, I had just paid like, Because I used to write on pen and pad. I used to always bring my pad to the studio and that. And then it just got ticky. But I just had pages of lyrics. So the first studio session, I think I banged out like 8 tracks. That's like fucking ridiculous, isn't it? In like the space of no time, innit? And then I was just like, fucking hell, this kid's mad, man. I was like, fuck, that's all my tracks done, man. That's me done.
Yeah, he had a task on his hands and he delivered. He didn't have a clue what he was doing. First time in a proper studio. This kid don't have the slightest of clue how capable and how interesting this could be.
When someone wants to open their heart, yeah, but their heart starts with insults.
Yeah. No, he's all right on days.
You know, days.
Mondays.
Can't take it for granted. You know, we appreciate selling out Islington O2, and the aim is to give them their money's worth, right? Make it make sense.
Oh yeah, fucking definitely.
And some. So, what really sold it is he messaged me to say happy Nigerian independence, maybe like a couple of weeks after we met. And it meant a lot because it was around a time where like there was a lot happening in terms of like racial tension, etc., etc. So it was just good to see a 19-year-old kid at that time that kind of understands that there's more cultures than the one that he was like born into, you know. But we continued going to the studio. No one knew what we were doing. Pretty much no one knew, like missus, parents, siblings. But it was a boot camp. Get in, build a sound.
Work ethic, the geezer doesn't stop, innit? I'm glad, I'm very lucky to have him as a manager.
Obviously,
doing story time with me.
Yeah.
Reminiscing
back in the day.
And last time you came here,
no tickets. No tickets.
Hopping fences.
VIP entry. With 100 other people, literally.
Good. Time to sit. Yesterday, my mum's birthday, I brought her out onto the stage. Singing to her, it was lit, so she was smashed.
The people know, 2016 Wireless, everyone was jumping on over the walls and that. That was my first ever festival. Only festival, apart from the ones that I performed at.
How you feeling? Good as always, bro. Good as always. Moving. Keep it moving. It's weird. I must not be all there, because I actually feel sweet, innit? Even the first time when I went on Leeds, I thought I was going to be like, fuck that. It's calm, innit?
Fame. Yeah. It's like, you can't do this and like have the upsides of this and that, and then unless you wear a mask, you know. But I haven't changed at all. I live life how I was living life before. Like, obviously, without the whole, I'm getting paid off music now, which is fucking great, godsend. But like, I still go pub, like do the same thing.
I remember the days I was out with the cats, weren't born for the trap, but I done that stuff. Nowadays I'll be out with a part and a fade, yeah, the galley think I'm large and buff. I guess life can get hard and tough, but you gotta break through, cause the hardest does. I was out on the main called Natch, in the rain with some fiends on that fairy dust. With them fiends with the fairy tales, I don't care, stop blind by the way that started. It's a shame where you are, but you came to the car for the crack, not chatting and parted. I got a gauge with a gun and a cartridge, shit, bruv.
Mom, I just French.
Yeah.
I don't know what that looks kind of. Looks kind of fucked, but listen. That's
how am I going to put them on eBay?
No rapper fucking. Is it?
That's it. No, I even gave it a speed strut at the bottom. Gave my H looks like a fucking chair.
Like, I feel like his audience understand who he is without him needing to oversell his narrative.
I could just release anything. And I don't think the supporters would be too surprised. if I release something completely different, I'm like, oh, it's just French, and that's just what he does. Like, you've got to find like little loopholes of what people actually like, but also you've got to like your music, otherwise it just doesn't make sense. I made a house beat in the studio the other day with my voice. You know how like they have like they lower the voice tune on the house, go, whoa, look like all that shit. I was doing it in the studio, just fucking about. Listen, wait for the mixtape innit, and you'll see. You'll be like, what the fuck? What is going on?
1, 2. Really good. Fucking phenomenal, mate. Literally, do you know what it is? Where it's like the most local show, just makes sense. Just like, see, I'm glad that it's here. I'm glad that the one that sold out of numbers is here. Tunnel vision. As soon as, like, before I get on a stage, cool, like, I might be a bit nervous and that, but as soon as I'm on stage, like, it's just, I don't even care. I don't even think of anything else. Like, I'm in my element, just confident. As soon as I get that mic, I just feel way more confident.
Kenny shouted me. Sorry. I don't even know where I was, but this is probably like 7 months into linking up with French.
Yeah.
When it was still about being underground and building, and Kenny shouted me, like, I think straight after the radio show.
Straight, yeah.
And I ain't heard that sincerity in someone's voice.
Honestly, I'm a fan. Yeah, I'm a fan. Is. Like, you see, there's moments where there's like an artist who excites me. It comes like maybe once every couple of years. Well, I know this guy is just gonna tear it up. His versatility, he's bilingual, he's just so slick with it, humble. I think he's going to the top, man. To the moon and back, and then back to the moon again, honestly. French the Kid,
amazing.
I'm a fan. Everybody that knows me on a Percy knows when I rock with you, I rock to the wheels fall, I forget what I'm saying. So big up French the Kid every single time. Get me? It's just the beginning, watch.
I loved every single part of the transition, to be honest. Getting paid off music, fucking like dream come true. People telling me how much like my music means to them. Them like singing the tunes, the performing, it's just mad, it's crazy.
Toys did I really had to wound up. Baby streaming got me ripped. Stacking my money for music, I'm selling my shit.
Stacking my room on the London, what the fuck is going on? Love that.
Bring the whole gang through. It's a mad feeling, especially when I'm performing through and they all come on the stage and that. Mad, I can't even explain to you like the feeling, it's crazy.
And the whole gang fly like a paper plane. She loves the way I make her feel. Told bro, step on the gas, I lay.
I'm incredibly proud. That was an amazing performance, bro. He's probably bored of hearing this. Like, you're a student. We're students to this. He has to absorb everything, and that's what's helped us. It's been very important to be ahead of the curve and not be reactive to it. You're like 2 months into performing to raise your game and to deliver when it matters is what counts, innit? Let this not be an isolated moment of celebration. We want to do this every year. We want to keep this moving. It requires work, but today, let's enjoy ourselves. It's mad important that these young kids, these young managers understand that they're capable of creating really like ambitious and rich content. You have to be ambitious with it, whatever that means to you.
Blue lights at the back of the car, no way, but she loves the thrill. You don't know me, but you know my face.
There's like a certain hunger you have before you're making money off music and you're releasing tunes and you're not making nothing and that. There's like a mad hunger. But as long as you keep like reminding yourself of that feeling, like, you'll be sweet.
I want everyone to make some fucking noise. SE's to London, you know what it is.
Listen.
Oh, you remember that French kid, like, he was different with it. That's what I want. Without being like the biggest or whatever, like people know that when my name's talked about, it's like, yeah, it's musically really there.
I love everyone, I love you, bro. Man, I say, I say, you say, I say.